You probably heard everything what you're gonna expect from a closing, except nobody told you about the house closing process for sellers. So I will right after this. Welcome back to my channel. I'm Esphir Popilevsky with Supreme Home Sales. I am a Staten Island realtor and a Staten Island resident. And I love helping you navigate the home selling process. So today I decided to help you understand the house closing process for sellers when you sell your house on Staten Island. One thing, closing could be overwhelming because you're gonna have a whole bunch of paperwork that you're gonna need to sign. Not as much as the buyer is signing, but still, there's quite a bit. So the attorney is going to go really quickly through the closing documents with you. So let me go over and tell you what they are so you feel comfortable when you sit there at the closing table. One of the documents you're gonna sign is the deed transfer document. So the deed, as you know, transfers ownership to the new buyer. So that would be one. The other document you will sign would be the smoke detector and carbon monoxide, a document that you are signing that they are present in the house and in working condition. The loan payoff document, if you still have a mortgage on the house, so you have to sign the loan payoff document so the title closer can actually pay off your loan and close it out. You will sign a document testifying and certifying that you're in fact is the owner of the house and you have the right to sell it. Another document might be a lead-based paint disclosure. That is if your house was built before 1978. So that would be a document that you will sign as well. And a document that we call a closing disclosure that some people may call it the HUD 1, which we don't use the terminology anymore. It was changed, but that closing disclosure will have all the money listed in there one by one. It would have the buyer side, it would have the seller side, everything that was paid from your closing on your behalf. So the buyer brings money, they have some payments that they have to add, and then whatever money is being transferred to you from that, and then whatever the title closer is going to pay on your behalf, the buyer brings the money, right? And then the attorney would have some of the buyer's money in their escrow account because the buyer made a deposit on escrow when they signed the contract. So everything is going to be listed on this closing disclosure, and you will get a copy of that. Everybody at the closing table gets a copy of that. So if you have a realtor, the realtor will get a copy, you'll get a copy, the buyer get a copy, the attorneys, the title closer, the bank attorney, everybody who's involved. Now that you want to know when you actually get your money, right? So I did a video about when the seller gets money after the closing. You can watch that next, and I will see you on Monday. Thank you for watching.